450 class from Salt Lake City. This is round number 16 of a 17-round championship. Ken Roczen in position to keep his title hopes alive. And Ricky, when the gate goes down in this 450 main, Ken Roczen, with a great gate pick up the inside, I know you like that, sneaks up the inside line. That's the first challenge, and he accomplished that one.
Yeah, he late breaks it, gets right up to the inside. He wanted to, I'm assuming he wanted to get that hole shot. Look, he is going to put in some really fast laps here on early. Cooper Webb, not an ideal start. He's up front, that wasn't ideal, but still, he had a lot of work ahead of him.
So Ken Roczen pulls away, nice comfortable lead. Cooper Webb's buried the field. You see Barsha go down right there, a lot of chaos behind the top three. But as Roczen is pulling away, makes a little bit of a mistake, loses that time. Joey Savacci with another rider up front. He had his issues.
He's had speed all day long, and yeah, just gets into that corner, asks too much out of that berm. That berm wasn't built up enough, and it gave way, and Savacci goes down.
Eli Tomac also loses the front end.
Same thing. He wasn't in that rut deep enough, loses the front end, pushes it, and down he goes down. I thought Eli Tomac had a good shot at the win today.
Clean laps by Ken Roczen, checked out a little bit, just 3-4 seconds, but then little mistake here, little mistake there. Marvin Muscan closes while the battle behind him rages on. Malcolm Stewart had a shot right there to take one on Cooper Webb, but didn't follow through, but
hey,
worked out later for him.
Kudos to Malcolm Stewart. I mean, he knows what's on the line for the championship, so he probably played a little bit nice there to his buddy Cooper Webb, which great riding, Malcolm. Deserve a lot of credit for that, and he didn't interfere with it, and that's a frustrating position to be in. But Cooper Webb was waiting, wait, I don't say he was waiting, but found his groove, found a little something there about halfway through the race. He goes by Jason Anderson, and he's going to set his sights on the front. And then this is where I think it started to go sideways with number 94.
Well, Muscan gets a little closer. You saw the pressure coming, and then that mistake right there, the longest, slowest washout ever, and Roczen's down.
Yeah, it was one of those, no. He goes down, gets trapped under the bike. Marvin Muscan goes by, Cooper Webb goes by, there goes Malcolm Stewart, and his teammate's gonna come right by the inside. Chase Sexton, was great comeback by Chase Sexton after his practice crash.
Now to the lead. Cooper Webb closes on Marvin Muscan. Ricky, he was looking for a way around. We thought he maybe had a spot, he just couldn't get close enough. Yeah. And he gets to the back tire of the 25.
And you got to give it to the 25. He rode superb. That's a lot of pressure to withstand. And he's been in this position before, but I was happy to see Marvin get the win.
Yeah, it's been 2 years since Marvin Muscan has won a Monster Energy Supercross, and he does it here in Salt Lake City. Ken Roczen fights back, gets a sixth place on the night, keeps the championship hopes alive, but now he's down 22. That's a lot of points to overcome, but Marvin Muscan, what a ride. He's been riding good this year, Ricky. He's had a lot of weird things happen to him, but on this night, it all works out for the 25.
Great start, perfect position, an incredible ride.
Muscan, Webb, and Malcolm Stewart with the first podium of his career. Great ride for all three of these riders. One more race in this championship.